This is Evolve Science X, where science meets survival. The global nuclear threat. Since the Cold War, the nature of nuclear threats has evolved. Today we face dangers not only from superpower standoffs, but from regional conflicts, rogue states, and the potential for nuclear terrorism. The bulletin of the Atomic Scientists' Doomsday Clock is now set to 90 seconds to midnight, the closest it has ever been to global catastrophe. Why? Because the risk of nuclear escalation is no longer hypothetical. The Russian invasion of Ukraine has intensified tensions. Russia has issued explicit threats to use nuclear weapons. Nuclear power plants like Chernobyl are once again in dangerous crosshairs. Meanwhile, conflict between Israel and Iran raises alarm over Iran's nuclear ambitions. Although Iran claims peaceful intentions, its uranium enrichment now nears weapons-grade levels. And the global stockpile? As of January 2025, Russia, 4,309 nuclear warheads. United States, 3,700 China, 600 France, 290. United Kingdom, 225 India, 180 Pakistan, 170 Israel, 90 North Korea, 50. Humanity stands on a thin edge. What happens? When a bomb drops? Imagine this. A 10-kiloton nuclear bomb detonates above your city, similar to those dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945. Within a 2-mile radius, total devastation. Thousands dead instantly. Seconds later, a shockwave collapses buildings. Then comes the radioactive fallout. If you're lucky enough to survive the blast, your fight for survival is only beginning. Immediate actions to take. In the event of a nuclear explosion, your survival depends on quick thinking and the right tools, many of which you already have at home. Let's break down what you need to do. Seek the right shelter. Radiation and shockwaves are your biggest threats. The safest shelters are basements and underground bunkers, interior rooms without windows like bathrooms or storage closets. Middle floors in large brick or concrete buildings avoid the top and bottom. Why middle floors? Because radioactive particles settle on rooftops and ground levels. Know what to do immediately. If you were outside during or after the blast, remove your clothes immediately and seal them in a plastic bag. The outer layer can carry up to 90% of radioactive particles. Next, shower with soap and warm water. Don't use conditioner. It traps radioactive material in your hair. Keep your pets inside, life-saving household items. Helmet. Protect yourself from falling debris after the shockwave. A bike or motorcycle helmet can prevent head trauma. If you don't have one, wrap thick clothes around your head. Cloth or mask. Use any cloth to cover your mouth and nose. Fallout dust will be thick in the air, and breathing it in can cause fatal radiation sickness. Sunglasses. A nuclear blast creates a flash of ultraviolet radiation that can cause temporary blindness within a 53-mile radius. Wear UV protective sunglasses to shield your eyes. Sunscreen and thick clothes. While sunscreen won't stop gamma radiation, it can help block UV rays and protect your skin from secondary burns and sun damage. Rubber or cleaning gloves. After the blast, your environment will be contaminated. Use gloves to avoid direct contact and reduce the risk of spreading radioactive material to your mouth, nose, and eyes. Battery-powered radio phones and the internet might go down, but radio broadcasts can still reach you. Tune in to emergency channels for life-saving information on where to go and what to avoid. Duct tape. Yes, duct tape can save your life. Use duct tape and plastic sheeting to completely seal windows, doors, and vents. Block airflow from the outside to prevent radioactive dust from entering your shelter. Prevent radiation from seeping into your home. Item 6. Potassium. Iodide pills. Shield your thyroid potassium. Iodide, often sold as potassium iodide pills or KI tablets. Most people don't keep these around, but in a nuclear emergency, they could save your life. When a nuclear explosion occurs, radioactive iodine is released into the air. If you breathe it in, it travels straight to your thyroid gland, where it can cause long-term damage, including cancer. Potassium iodide works by flooding your thyroid with safe, stable iodine. This blocks radioactive iodine from being absorbed. One pill can protect your thyroid for up to 24 hours. But be careful. Taking too much can be dangerous or even fatal. Always follow the dosage instructions exactly. Store them in your emergency kit. And only use them when directed by public health officials. Item 7. Flashlight and warm clothing, surviving the darkness. After a nuclear detonation, the skies will turn dark. Fallout clouds, dust, and debris will block out sunlight, making it nearly impossible to see, even during the day. A high-powered flashlight can help you navigate in the darkness, avoid hazards, and signal for help. Choose one that's durable, waterproof, and battery efficient. Also, temperatures will plummet. Without sunlight, it gets cold fast. Keep a warm, insulated jacket in your emergency kit. Hypothermia can be just as deadly as radiation if you're not prepared. Emergency food and water supplies. Next, you'll need food and clean drinking water. After a nuclear event, going outside is dangerous. Fallout can contaminate everything, including water sources and soil. You'll need to shelter in place for at least 48 hours. That means having enough supplies to survive indoors. Store non-perishable, ready-to-eat meals, canned beans, tuna, beef jerky, protein bars. Choose foods that are high in energy and require no cooking. Don't count on using your stove or fridge power, and gas lines will likely be down. Water is critical. Aim for at least 1 gallon of clean, bottled water per person, per day. Keep a supply that can last you and your family at least 3 days. Never drink from outdoor sources. After a blast, they may be radioactive. Mobility and emergency packing tips. If you need to leave your shelter, whether to find help or relocate to a safer area, mobility becomes your top priority. Prepare an emergency backpack in advance. It should include compact, high-energy food, water, a flashlight, warm clothing, and your potassium iodide pills. Only pack what you can carry. In a crisis, speed matters, and you may need to move fast on foot. Survival is about being ready, being calm, and being smart. Planning ahead gives you the edge you need when time is short and danger is close. Conclusion: you can't control when or where disaster will strike, but you can control how prepared you are. Take these steps today. Get the supplies. Make the plan. Because when seconds count, being ready makes all the difference. Stay safe. Stay strong.